A majority of people who are young voted to remain. I accept that totally. But if you look at the statistics, about 45% of young working class people voted to leave. What about those people? It's our future too, you know. You know, millions of young people did vote to remain, but there are plenty of young people who also voted to leave. Now, as people, his argument is that in 5 years' time, the will of the people will change because older people will die off. Well, how do the Conservatives keep winning elections if that's true?
Because you're more likely to vote Tory if you are older than
exactly.
If you're younger.
The last 7 years, the Conservatives have won 3 elections. I'm sure a lot of old people have died in the last 7 years, but the Conservative vote has actually increased. As you go older, you become more conservative. And my point is, as you go older, people will become more pro-Brexit. And that's how it will work with young people as well.
Well, I've always found it quite bizarre, this idea that, you know, I've done quite a few debates on television and radio over the years where there's always a young person who gets, of course, a huge round of applause because they're young. Almost, it seems to me that the amount of times they'll say something like, you know, but this is my future. I'm going to live a lot longer with these consequences. The argument that Femi was making yesterday. And as I said in one response, well, you know, I'm only 49. I'm not planning to die anytime soon. I had a granny live to 96. I'm hoping for another 50 years, frankly. I'm going to live with the consequences. And if we are going to argue that some people don't have to live with the consequences so long, are we arguing in some way that young people's votes should count for more?
Well, exactly. It's like saying that older people have, you know, less of a decision over our lives. That's not how democracy works. One vote equals one vote. It doesn't matter who you are. You know, young people don't deserve more of a voice than older people. It's actually quite disrespectful to say that. Couldn't young people consider for one moment that maybe older people have more experience and a bit wiser, and you know that they've had to live with the consequences of being in the EU for the last 43 years. Surely those people deserve a voice just as much as young people.
Well,
you know,
I was certainly a Remainer. I don't think I became Eurosceptic until, gosh, well into my late 30s. Still long before it was fashionable, I'd like to say. But this is the thing. It's one of those things that I've come to from experience, from, you know, writing as a political journalist about it. Now, but you and I are very much in agreement on this particular, this one issue on Brexit. But I do think there is an argument that the likes of Femi do have about young people feeling that their voice is not heard in a lot of areas of politics. And we did see this massive change, didn't we, in the EU referendum, where a huge number, I think 2/3 of young people voted for the first time. Now, previously, it's always less than half. There are always more, in every general election there's ever been, there have been more people who are under 24 who don't vote than do vote, even though they've got six years in which they've got that vote and they don't bother using it. But we did see there was a lot of talk about this this revolution, this youthquake, people were calling it, in the 2017 general election, how this had transformed Jeremy Corbyn, the Labour Party had transformed. But it now appears that actually it wasn't a lot of young people voting for Labour or suddenly coming out to vote. It was actually people in their late 20s and their 30s and even their 40s who were going out to vote for Jeremy Corbyn. Do you think that the biggest issue actually with young people is not that, oh, their future's being stolen by nasty Brexit voters like you and me, but actually that they're stealing their own future by not going out to vote? Because I've got to be honest, if Remain had won and there had been the same level of turnout among young people as there was among people of my age group, I'd have been perfectly happy with that result.
You know what? I couldn't even vote in the referendum. I was too young to vote. I was 16 at the time. But I spent all my weekends going out campaigning to leave. All my friends who wanted to remain in the EU didn't do that. They didn't go out and campaign, and a lot of them didn't vote. If young people really want to change this country and for the better, they better stop complaining. Stop complaining about Brexit. Move on. We've had 17.4 million people have voted for it, and what they should do is try and engage with the positives of Brexit and try and engage with the opportunities of Brexit. There are so many good positive things that can come out of Brexit for young people. So a really good example of this is tariffs that the EU impose on goods. So as soon as we leave the customs union, we can get rid of those protectionist barriers, and we can make goods cheaper for young people. So for example, food and clothes will be a lot cheaper if we remove those tariffs.
Because people forget, although we've got a single market within the EU, that's part of the customs union, what that actually imposes is tariffs on the outside.
Exactly,
world.
Yeah, an external tariff on countries that are much poorer than us.
But how come so many young people are so keen on Remain? Why do so many young people view the EU as this force for good? I'm perfectly happy people to have that view. I'm intrigued by why there is this big generational difference.
I think there's a lot of press around the EU, positive press for young people. So they see it as this amazing super bloc where you can go and travel for free, you can go and work, you can go and study across Europe, you can have free mobile phone charges. Although most people never do that, and you can in fact travel anywhere around the world these days. You know, visa-free travel is massively increasing. You can go to the States, whatever. So yeah, they see it as, and also university lecturers are massively pro pro-European. I mean, you wonder why so many young people voted to remain. Just look at our university lecturers, look at the schools. They're really pro-EU. They've got funding from the European
Union. Did you have this? I mean, you're at college. Have you had this?
Yeah,
from your
I've
teachers?
Seen a lot of teachers very pro-EU. And, you know, if you say a different opinion, you get shouted down and you get looked down upon.
Is there also just a view that, again, we've had this whole leave voters, oh, we're old, we're backward looking, little England, we're xenophobic, we're racist, we're not open to the, you know, all of that stuff. Has that sort of permeated through youth culture?
Yeah, I think so, because when you see headlines from the Daily Mail about immigrants, I think young people really respond to that because they see that as a negative. Yeah. But in reality, if we look at the actual issue, being able to control our borders could actually help young people. So the Bank of England say that...
Well, they're going to be competing with Eastern Europeans coming in who've got far more experience than them.
So the Bank of England says that a 10% increase in migration lowers wages by 2% for the people who are lowest paid in society, and that is young people, low-skilled jobs. As we begin to control our borders and reduce immigration from the EU, young people's wages could actually see to increase, and also the pressure on house prices and renting costs. The less immigration we have, the better it is for young people in terms of those issues, which are really big issues for young people at the moment.
Do you know what? I've had a light bulb moment. I say we get Stephen Edgerton back in the studio and Femi Oluwole, and we get them to debate the youth of today. Although, to be fair, Femi's a little bit older, about 10 years on you, I think. We'll get both of you into a debate these issues.